हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे इन द कनेक्शन ऑफ द टॉपिक, इन कनेक्शन टू द सिलेबस, आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लेसन ऑन द नोवल आज़ादी, साइको एनालिसिस ऑफ चमन हाल्स नोवल। साइको एनालिसिस, यू नो दैट हाउ द राइटर हैज डीपली ऑब्जर्व द करेक्टर्स, डीपली ऑब्जर्व द contents, deeply observed the theme. He has tried to present his psychological theory on the contents. This topic deals with the partition between India and Pakistan. After partition, how people became mentally sick and psychologically depressed. Chaman Hall depicted a photographic details the catastrophic episode that was enacted on the Indian soil immediately before and after the declaration of the British decision on June 1947 to vacate India after partitioning it. Nahal showed how people of Pakistan have been living together with peace and harmony. But after the partition, world is shaped by the creation of Pakistan. There are keywords: human psyche, massacre, bloodshed, partition, trauma, rape, violence, socio-psychology. These words occur frequently in the novel. Psychology is the scientific study of how people's thoughts, feelings and behavior are influenced by the actual imagined or implied presence of others. Social psychologists therefore deal with the factors that lead us to behave in a given way in the presence of others and look at the conditions under which certain behaviors, actions and feelings, thoughts, beliefs, intentions and goals are constructed and how such psychological factors in turn influence our interaction with others. The term socio-psychological means factors which are related to the society and psychology which are ultimately related to the life. So in the paragraph, Chaman Hall has tried to show that how the situation before and after the partition was very revolutionary, how the change in behavior of the people occurred before the partition and after the partition. The people, the society and psychology are deeply related to each other. So we can say that when the writer is able to highlight this, his psychological matters, that means that the society around him has put the effect upon his mind, by which the discloses it in the form of his volumes. Any writer, whatever he writes, is called as the voice of time, especially of his contemporary time, because he is the testimonial of the happenings around him. Azadi is the major novel of Chaman Hall. The novel Azadi deals with the theme of partition of Indian subcontinent into India and Pakistan. As Chaman Hall himself was a refugee, he writes with remarkable penetration and realism. The novel is historical, political, and above all, a great work of art. It offers the most comprehensive treatment of the colossal tragedy to date. Azadi won the Sahitya Academy Award. The novel depicts in photographic detail the catastrophic episode that was enacted on the Indian soil immediately before and after the declaration of the British decision in June 1947 to vacate India after partitioning it. Azadi is certainly perhaps the most comprehensive presentation of the partition holocaust in Indian English fiction. It contains some moving episodes, but there are some serious limitations, like conventional romantic touches, an overplus of sex and a faulty narrative strategy. It is a matter of account of a well-to-do Hindu grain merchant and his family. The partition of India was the route of separating the subcontinent along parochial lines in 1947 as India achieved its independence from British Empire. It led into a Muslim-dominating northern state of Pakistan and Hindu-predominating southern part became the Republic of India. Partition, however, demolished both India and Pakistan as it averted many lives in riots, rapes, murders and looting, but about 15 million people were displaced from their homes. The two countries commenced their independence with bust economies and lands without an entrenched competent system of government. Samar Nahal's Azadi is a modern classic which conceals an inclusive revelation of life, signifying the cues that partition played on the people of the country, both at the social and individual levels. It portrays the realistic historical documentation of the atrocious confrontations caused by the partition through literary retrospective. H. Chaman Nahal himself was a refugee. He writes with incredible ingrace and realism. Therefore, he has written his own experience through the character of Lala Kasiram and his son Varun. The novel is about the mum environment before the declaration of partition, the awful incidents caused by the partition, and the rest circumstances of the deracinated refugees after the partition. Azadi is the story of Lala Kasiram and his family living in Sialkot, and on the universal plane of the people exaggerated by the partition. Lala Kasiram, the protagonist, a wholesale grain merchant in Sialkot, has earned name, fame, destiny by working very hard. His son Aruna, college student, and his beloved wife Prabharani makes his family life quite happy. The Lal very closely accustoms us with Lala Kasiram, who is a distinctive Indian of the time and whose ideal is Mahatma Gandhi. Through a statement of belief, he is a nationalist Hindu living in the Muslim majority Sialkot. He loves his land and is at this juncture in Sialkot that his father and forefather lived. The British, according to him, be obliged to quit India and give Azadi to the Indians, and he writes, like any other Indian, he had a prejudice against the British. He hated them for what they had done to his country and wanted Azadi. However, the social atmosphere in the country is an utterly chaos. The Punjabis are kept under perpetual tension, and the Muslims as well as the Sikhs fail to guess anything about the partition. The selfish leaders play their role very shrewdly, only few men sitting and deciding the fate of the millions. The Arya Samajist Lala hopes to achieve freedom with an individual, undivided India. The Lala speaks in Punjabi, then writes in Urdu. For him, Urdu is not the language socially of Muslim. In his mind, there is no grudge against the Muslims, but he is aware of their attitude towards Hindus and Sikhs. He has firm faith in Gandhi and is sure that he will never agree to a division of the country. However, he is deeply worried that everything will be ruined if Pakistan is created. Hindus, Sikhs, Muslims have been living together in peace and harmony for many decades. In the Punjab city of Sialkot, Kasiram's world is shaken by the creation of the Pakistan, and he stands as a shattered individual. His cherished beliefs and values not giving him support, events are presented through the consciousness of Lala Azadi hurriedly. As a result, Arunad Noor and also Barkat Ali and Lala curse the hastily achieved freedom and the instantaneous partition. It is on the 24th June the Muslim friends of the Lala kill a number of Hindus, and then it becomes a daily ritual. It is reported that the Muslim refugees from India come to Sialkot in a heartbroken condition, telling the stories of molestations and massacre by Hindus and Sikhs. This provokes the Muslims to kill the Hindus, who begin to go to the refugee camps and then to India. Whatever the Muslims did to us in Pakistan, we were doing it to them. And he feels miserably repentant and seeks to apologize all the Muslims on behalf of all the Hindus when he says, "We have sinned as much. We need their forgiveness." The novelist, however, demonstrates that even after partition, some Muslims stand for communal harmony. Chaudhry Barkat Ali is one such large-hearted person who doesn't support any anti-Hindu violence. O.P. Mathur opines that Lala takes a stance which clearly demonstrates his freedom from commitment to anything except love, compassion, tolerance, and forgiveness. In a word, freedom of spirit and mind, which alone makes political freedom meaningful. The superficial differences of religion peel off and reveal the essential humanity of man and the idiocy of the evil that seeks to raise artificial walls of hatred between one human being and another. In advance, the Congress was not ready for any kind of division of the subcontinent. Nevertheless, finally, the leaders of Congress party were also circumstances to accept it as it became an inevitable alternative. Thus, the genuine responsibility of the partition goes to Jinnah and his Muslim League. Of course, Jinnah was not the first person to sow the seeds of separatist tendencies. It was smooth before 1867 that Muslims like Sir Syed Ahmed Chaudhry, Ahmed Ali, Muhammad Iqbal tried too hard to create a separate Muslim nation. The Congress, on the other hand, tried to maintain synchronization between the two communities, but unfortunately, the Indian leaders failed to keep the Hindus and the Muslims together. And in 1947, the vast Indian subcontinent was partitioned. In Azadi, Nahal's purpose is to describe the impact of the partition on the ordinary people. He portrays the pain Lala Kasiram and his family of Sialkot, now in Pakistan, goes through due to partition and their alienation from their own homeland. This reflects the suffering of the millions of people who are uprooted and forced to migrate to India. People sadly realize that they are unwanted in their own native places and that Azadi brings only untold misery and uncertain future. Nahal describes the excruciating experiences of the uprooted people in refugee camps and on their way to India, traveling on foot, in convoys, and submitting themselves helplessly to violence of all sorts, arson, murder, abduction, and rape. After arriving in India, much suffering awaits them in their own free country at the hands of an indifferent and callous bureaucracy. He does not take sides and blames both Hindus and Muslims communities for their sadistic animalism. Punjabis grieve more for loss of identity than the loss of life and property. Nahal understands this crisis of identity and portrays it in profoundly than other partisan writers who either treat it superficially or ignore it totally. Azadi, the last novel of Gandhian Quartet, highlights the psychological consequences of the partition. It is centered around the Hindu family of Lala Kansiram, a grain merchant in the city of Sialkot. It also deals with the political, social, economic, religious, psychological, and cultural implications of Azadi, which India achieved in 1947. In this novel, the writer has projected the image of Gandhi as a contrast to the other national leaders. Through Lala Kansiram, Nahal voices the confidence and faith of a common man in Gandhi. Kansiram believes that Gandhi will never let partition happen. He says the Congress had promised to keep with the people for the last 30 years since the wizard Gandhi came on the scene. It has taken the stand that India was a single nation, not two. And Gandhi was not only a politician, he was a saint. He had his inner voice to satisfy too. Would that nagging voice of his late him accept the slaughter of so many? That is what it would mean if Pakistan did come into existence and Gandhi was shrewd, surely he saw it all. He would not give in to such boozery. If nothing else worked, his fast into death always did. In Azadi, Pandit Nehru comes in for severe criticism when there is fever of partition. He is blamed and held responsible for the partition. This sentiment is expressed through Lala Kansiram. He reacts furiously to Nehru's role in partition politics. In this respect, he says, "What stupid thing was he talking about? Was it really Nehru? The drawl was the same, the emotion in the words was the same. The disjointed queer Hindu syntax was his alone, but what had happened to his akal, his mind, akal, his mind have partitioned. There is no other way, have it that way, we are willing to make sacrifices. But what nonsense was this of no panic, no violence, full protection from the government, peace the main object, heady government." These were the views about Nehru, who supported or not to the partition of India. So, we have also seen the life of Sialkot, the career and life of Lala Kansiram regarding the partition of India. There are so many examples how all the communities, Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, suffered and faced the challenges. Even the brutal behavior of the police was very crucial, and how the train from Pakistan to India approached, how was the very crucial scene in them. So we have also seen many things. Although the chapter is very lengthy, but I have tried to teach you in a very summarizing manner. Now we come to the conclusion. Thus Lala realizes that forgiveness is the only way to recover one's sanity, one's humanity, and to live in peace with oneself. It is not only story of Lala but himself, oneself. It is not only but millions of people like him. Nahal stretches through the protagonist Lala Kasiram the necessity of human forgiveness, lying to emphasis on the affirmation of life to which he is committed. J.M. Purut endorses this view when he says, almost all his novels end with optimistic vision. Partition resulted in the monstrous Holocaust ever witnessed. There was wholesale destruction due to communal frenzy, and the whole balance of human relationships is upset. Yet the novel reveals a ray of hope and regeneration before it closes. This prompts Asa Kaushik to remark that although beginning on a note of ambivalence and uncertainties of national integrity in the face of religious fanaticism, moral degradation, moral or political fragmentation, Azadi closes with the affirmation that a nation outlives even annihilating tragedies. The partition of the subcontinent in 1947 was the most inauspicious incident in the history of Indian freedom struggle. Tens of thousands of people were killed and an equal number of people were rendered homeless and injured. The extraordinary migration and that took place during those days had no parallel in history. Whereas taking a brief assessment of the partition, it becomes clear that it was the Muslim communique launched by the Muslim League's two-nation theory that gave birth to partition. Thank you, students. You have understood the content. Thank you.